Fine. So we were talking about the voltage follower circuit. In the voltage follower circuit, the input impedance is very, very high. So the current requirement from the input signal will be very, very low. Whereas at the output end, we will get sufficient current to drive any other circuit, right? So it is like an amplifier. Let us say an amplifier will, what will it do? In amplifier, we have a weak signal of the mic, which is connected to the amplifier, and the output is connected to the speaker, and the speaker are actually the high power. It is a high power load, which requires some power, right? So it depends on how much power you feed, right? So the speaker will give you the sound output. It will again convert the signal back to the sound, right? So the output of the speaker depends on the signal strength. So this is the purpose of the low output impedance, right? If we get sufficient current, then we can drive the other load. Fine. Now the inverting amplifier. So in op amp, which is connected as an inverting amplifier with a controlled amount of voltage gain, is shown. This is shown in figure. See, the input voltage is connected through the resistance to the inverting terminal, negative. Okay, whereas the non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground. Okay, the non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground, and there is an output. The output is fed back through the resistance RF back to the input, same input. Okay, so how does this help? Let us see. So the inverting input amplifier can be the op amp here can be represented as the equivalent circuit, right? This is what we studied in the last lecture, right? That we have an input voltage, and then it is given to the infinite. We have infinite input impedance, ideally. Okay, ideally we have infinite input impedance. What will happen when we have an infinite input impedance? Then the current through the open circuit will be zero. We know that the current through the circuit will be zero if the circuit is open circuit, right? What does this mean? It means that the current which will flow from RI to the inverting terminal through the op amp to the non-inverting terminal to the ground, this current is going to be zero. If the current is zero, what will happen to the differential voltage, right? So here we have ID into Z in, let us say. Okay, so then the V differential is V difference, and that is the voltage drop here, voltage drop in the input impedance. So V difference is equal to 0 into Z in, because the current is 0. So the Z in is multiplied with 0, so it will be 0. That means the voltage drop in from inverting terminal to the non-inverting terminal is 0. I can say that it is almost short, right? So what will happen? Because the voltage potential, or to be precise, because the potential at non-inverting terminal is 0, and the drop between non-inverting terminal and the inverting terminal is 0, that means the potential at this point, the junction, will also be 0, right? This concept is known as virtual ground. So that means the point of connection between the input impedance and the feedback resistance is called virtual ground. Virtual ground, it has ground, because it is ground, so the potential is zero. So how does this help, right? So let us see there is a virtual ground here, 0 volt here, right? So there will be an input current, right? And this input current, because there is no current going through inverting to the non-inverting terminal, so whatever is the input current, same will be the feedback current. Okay, same will be the feedback current. So I in is equal, because I in is incoming. Okay, on, and it is and there is no current at I1, so you have IF. So IF, whatever is the incoming current, what same is the outgoing current, right? That's why I in is equal to IF. Now how do you determine I in? The I in is equal to potential V in minus zero, that is potential difference. Remember, how do you calculate the current? It is potential difference divided by the resistance. So potential is V in minus zero divided by Ri, that is the resistance, right? So this is given by V in by Ri. That means input current is equal to V in by Ri. On the other hand, the feedback current is given by what? Zero. What is, let us have a look at the direction of the current. We consider that it is going from zero to V out, right? Sorry. So it is zero minus V out, right? Divided by Rf. That means feedback current is equal to minus V out by Rf. What is the meaning of minus sign here? It means that the actual current will be flowing in the reverse direction. Okay. So now, since we have a relation that feedback current is equal to input current, so minus V out upon Rf is equal to V in upon Ri. Now, if we rearrange these terms, that means take V in at the denominator and Rf at numerator. So we just swap the position of V in and Rf, then V out upon V in is equal to minus Rf by Ri. Okay. But we also know that V out upon V in is the closed loop voltage gain, ACL. So ACL, that is the closed loop voltage gain, is given by minus Rf upon Ri. Okay. Now, based on this, we have another example, right? This example will, this link will be available in your chat section again.